Hi, it's John Keeney at my local business online, and today I want to show you how to add a pay with a tweet button to your blog post or to your website, whichever you're using. Pay with a tweet allows you to provide information on another hidden web page or a free download, maybe an ebook, a PDF, or even a video, whatever you are offering, and for people to receive that information, they pay with a tweet. That's why it's called pay with a tweet. And to do that, you get this little button and you put it on your website, and when you click it, you get this pop-up to sign in with Twitter or connect with Facebook, because you can also pay with a share on Facebook. And this is done with a nifty little tool. Oddly, it's called pay with a tweet, and I'm going to show you how to set that up. So here we are, this is paywithatweet.com/sell.php, and it takes you straight to the create a button, and you fill out the form as it asks with your name and your email, and your file name is what you have called the file name. So we'll just put in an example, my free download. And the download URL. Now this is where the download or the page that you're sending them to is located. So this isn't shared until people have clicked the tweet or share button. So you've got to put the correct URL in there. So include the HTTP. So you include the full file name, and the next box is where you define the tweet that can be posted. Now you've got 110 characters, and this can be changed by whoever's posting the tweet or sharing to Facebook. So I downloaded this cool info. And the next box is the page where you are actually having your pay with a tweet button. So it's this URL here. Now if you're just writing your blog post, if I flick over and you're writing your blog post, it's this permalink here. So I would copy and paste this section at the top here. If I copy that, I can post it into Bitly to create a short URL, because we've only got a very limited number of characters. It's 29 characters, and you've got to fit it all in. Bitly is free to use. Just pop over and create an account. So it's bit.ly, and for example, I can copy one that's already there. So I'm going to copy that one and post it in there, including the HTTP. Now be careful here, see how it leaves a space between the forward slashes and the B? So you want to press the backspace and make sure that that URL is a proper URL, so that when you click on it, it actually goes to where you need to be. So once you've got all your information in there, add in the capture and create the button. And now you've got a choice of buttons to use. You can even have a QR code, which is great if you're doing some mobile marketing. Okay, so this is the one I use, pay with a tweet or Facebook. All of them will allow you to pay with a tweet or Facebook. So select all the information and copy that. Pop back over to your blog post. Now you don't want to paste it straight in to here, you want to put it into the HTML, so you click on the text tab and paste it in there. When you click back onto visual, you'll see this red box appear. Now if we click preview, you'll see there's our pay with a tweet, and because we haven't put a real URL in there, there's very little point in tweeting it. But if someone clicks on it, they'll get the pop-up box like this. And if I sign in with Twitter now, And it says here, I discovered a really easy way to get more retweets, likes and plus ones. I can change that, and obviously your readers can change that. And there's the bit.ly URL, and I can pay with a tweet. And it comes up with a pop-up saying, you sure you want to do it? Click OK. And it should go to the download page. You can click Get It Now. It's a little bit slow loading up, but there's the PDF that I've just paid for. And that's how simple it is. So make sure if you're using the bit.ly shortener, if I flick back over to here and go back, that you do remove the spaces if you've copied it straight over from bit.ly, that the URL is a complete URL with no spaces. And that's it. I'll speak to you soon.